Now, this video is about comparing septic tanks to biodigesters. I'm going to explain to you what biodigesters are. One, I'm also going to tell you about septic tanks as an alternative means of toilet wastewater management. I'm going to open it up and then give you the advantages of either one of them. When you intend on constructing a biodigester, you have two options. Either the footing of the building is up enough, and then the pipe that is coming into the digester has got a very good gentle slope or gentle gradient, then it can come and fall in at the top part of the digester. So let's say it's a 3-bedroom house and you intend on constructing a biodigester. The depth of the digester is basically 3 feet. So the pipe that is coming from the house will have to come at an angle and in such a way that you would then not require it falling at the base of the digester, which you then will render it ineffective. So then that's why sometimes we recommend people use P-trap when they're going to do a biodigester, and if their area or the location is not ground that can soak the water. In terms of their installation, in terms of installing or construction of biodigesters, it can be done in a day. If you are using precast or prefabricated slabs for the construction, it can be done in less than 5 hours. If you are using blocks, you have to consider 2 days maximum, because it means that you have to do the top slab and wait for it to dry and then lay the blocks, and then you can do the inside bedding before covering it up. But if you compare it to a septic tank, you have to do the concrete works, you have to lay the blocks, and then you have to cast the top slab as well, because most of the time the location of the septic tank will require you having a cast concrete done on it so that the car can walk on it, or other things can also be done on it, because probably it's also requiring a lot of space on your compound or in the house. You will need that space also to do other things, and that's why when you're doing a septic tank, it might take you sometimes 2 weeks, sometimes take 3 weeks for it to be done. With biodigesters, you are not in that space, you are not in that time frame, and you are not on that timeline, because when the space required, the depth is also not deep, and then the materials required are not that much. So that's another comparison of septic tanks to biodigesters. Septic tanks, the soakaway is attached to the tank itself, or the soakaway is virtually non-existent, because then the human waste and the water are all together in the tank. And then the hope and prayer is that the human waste will settle down, and then the water can overflow into the next chamber, and then subsequently into a soakaway if there's one, or into an overflow tank, right? So with biodigesters, the difference is that there's going to be a rapid separation of the waste from the digester immediately you flush, so that the water goes into the soak hole or goes into a whatever option that you have there, and then the human waste is what stays in the digester for the microorganism to feed on it. Another comparison of the septic tank to the biodigester is the amount of money required in their construction and the time it takes for them to be constructed. Obviously, because of the size of the septic tank, it will require you a longer time to have it constructed, and the materials that you might need for the septic tank will be higher. So let's say you are doing a septic tank, a 10 by 10 septic tank, you might require about 300 blocks. Then you might need your iron rod, you might need the concrete to be done at the base, you might need the plastering, and the number of cement that will be required will also be there. So all those things will go into determining the cost for you when it comes to septic tank. On the other hand, when it comes to a biodigester and you need a standard biodigester for a family of let's say 4 or 3, you need about 50 blocks, you need a 38 mm water rod, 6 of them for your top slab, you need about 3 or 4 cement, and then you need the inside materials that will help. And of course, you need the soak away to be done, or the soak hole to be done, and then a few blocks or stones that will have to go into it to help with the water filtration. So if you are deciding to choose what type of wastewater management you will need for your house, and you are going to decide between a septic tank and a biodigester, you will have to consider the cost that's also involved. You will also have to consider the space that is required when it comes to either one of these. Septic tank will require you a bigger space, and then the digester will obviously require a small space. It can go at the back of the building and it can be hidden there. The other difference is that the septic tank can be done in front of the house, but then the car can park on it, and then it can be done firmly and then it can be placed that you will not have a problem whenever it's time for you to dislodge. Comparing this digester, usually prefer the digester located in such a place that you do not let cars park on it. If you intend to do a digester for a car to park on it, it means that you have to do reinforcement, you have to do a lot of concrete works. Then when it comes to the time for you to do maintenance, then it means that all those concretes will have to be broken down. And then from experience, most of the time it's best to do the digester because of the space that's required, and just at the back or at a nice place where you do not need a car to work on it. So that's one of the considerations that you have to make when you are also considering one of this technology. The other one is the smell or the scent that generated from either one of this technology. I have used both of them, I've constructed both of them before, and I'm sure you are also aware that the septic tank will breed odor, will breed smell, especially when it's time the truck to come and have the human waste dislodged from the house. It's mainly because the human waste together with the water and the bacteria that are in it that generate the maggots and all those bad bacteria with to smell that aid in the decomposition are not doing the work well. So that's why the human waste smells when you have a septic tank and it's time to have it destroyed. And then you see the flies around sometimes as well. The biodigester is fly free. It's also odorless. I've told some people it's odorless and they don't believe me. It's a simple reason because, let's say, the moment you separate the human waste from the water, what is left is basically something that will break down. So obviously it will not attract flies and it will not also smell. That's one side of the digester where it is odorless, is fly free. The reason why biodigesters became very big in Ghana is because of how safe they are for the environment. And it's also because then we have been using the septic tank over the years. The mode and the method of the treatment of the sludge, the solid waste, has become a problem for us. Most of the time, over the years in Accra especially, there's a famous place we are calling the Lavender Hill. If you go there, you see the tanks bring the sludge and the solid waste for treatment. Then it's not treated enough and then it's being dumped into the sea, because then that's the only option that we have in terms of the treatment. With the biodigesters, the idea is that you can treat it at your backyard. It's also known as a simple on-site wastewater management treatment system. It means that the solid waste is treated at your backyard. It's time for you to dislodge or to do maintenance or remove the remains in it. And it can be taken out because there's virtually nothing in it. It can be dug and can be put at the backyard of your house. With digesters, you do not need a truck to dislodge. With septic tanks, you require a truck sludging by the solid waste is carried away, be treated at a plant or at a site. So if you are considering any of these two, these are a few of the comparisons that you can look at. Then the one that you think will serve you best is what you are supposed to look at. Space required is one. The dislodging in terms of the cost, if you have to have maintenance or dislodging done, is two. And then the amount of money required to have either one of them constructed, three. Environmental safety, how conducive are they to the environment, is four. Then the quick in terms of the timelines for its construction is also five. I'm also looking at whether the smell or the environment, how safe they are for the environment. All these things must be compared when you are looking at